Former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo is also in Bangkok as part of the Philippine delegation to the APEC summit. House Speaker Martin Romualdez says it was Marcos who invited Arroyo to join them. He also called the former president and senior House Deputy Speaker an asset for the Philippines.
Her reputation, her track record, you know, it's no deduction to anyone. And her advice, her counsel to our president, President Marcos, right now is invaluable. We not only really have, you know, a president, but a former president who's known as an economist.
A security analyst urges President Marcos to stay true to his promise of asserting the rights of the Philippines in the South China Sea during his state visit to China next year. Marcos had said holding diplomatic discussions with Beijing to assert Manila's sovereignty is the best option for the Philippines since it cannot risk going into war with China. For Dindo Manhit, president of Strat-based ADR Institute, the Marcos administration should look at the dispute beyond China and the Philippines.
I go back to, we are a small country that can be bigger, can be stronger, but that strength that cannot emanate from us alone, but can emanate from our own partnership, our strategic partnerships, our alliances with other countries that share our values, that respect our victory with regards to West Philippine Sea territorial issues.
The Philippine Defense Department believes the upcoming visit of U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris to Palawan will not have an impact on the situation in the West Philippine Sea. The agency says Harris's visit will be no different from other foreign dignitaries who previously came to the country. It adds Harris will be visiting residents there and checking on the Philippine Coast Guard, which, he notes, is a civilian agency. Harris is set to arrive in the Philippines on November 20 and visit Palawan on the 22nd. China claims territories in the waters off Palawan and much of the South China Sea, including the Spratlys, where it has built runways and weapons systems. In other news, Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the excavation site found in the New Bilibid prison was originally meant for treasure hunting. Remulla claims suspended Prisons Bureau Chief Gerald Bantag personally told him he was digging for the Yamashita treasure, which began sometime in August or September.
Ridiculous nga eh. Tsaka you're just wasting government time and money eh, diba? Hindi ko alam kung government time and money ginamit niya, pero ridiculous para sa akin. You're not there to seek for treasure. You're there to run the corrections department.
In a TV interview, Bantag claimed the excavation was intended to build a deep swimming pool since he is a scuba diver. Bureau of Corrections officer in charge, Gregorio Katapang Jr., first disclosed the matter last week. He said the tunnel, which is about 200 meters by 200 meters wide and 30 meters deep, had no paperwork and was not authorized by the Bureau. Alleged human rights abuses inside the state penitentiary come to light. In this exclusive report by Michael Delizo, an inmate details what he described as the abusive leadership at the New Bilibid prison. Aside from the South China Sea issue, the two leaders also talked about cooperation when it comes to agriculture and infrastructure. President Xi Jinping said China wants to import more agriculture products from the Philippines, highlighting the planned entry of durian to the Chinese market. China also donated 20,000 tons of urea fertilizers to the Philippines. Both leaders, meanwhile, agreed to consider working together on more infrastructure projects. Marcos and Xi will meet again in January during the Philippine leaders' state visit to China.